The FBI in Peace and War, ordinarily heard at this time throughout the year, is taking its usual summer vacation and will return to CBS 1 week from tonight on September 1st.
Broadway's My Beat. From Times Square to Columbus Circle, the gaudiest, the most violent, the lonesomest mile in the world.
Broadway's My Beat, with Larry Thor as Detective Danny Clover.
Broadway, it's a swamp that'll drag you breath by breath into its shadowed pools, or it's a meadow shining with golden light. It's a place and a time and a loneliness that reaches out for you, then beckons you into an airless room and locks the door. And you get out or you don't. Either way, it's Broadway, My Beat. A man dies in silence and in dark, and the city sets up a shrieking clamor, and you're part of it. You ride a scream through the crowded, heat-heavy streets, and then you hit a dead end. And it's a building, and a room at the top of the building, and it's a man lying in the center of the room while other men take notes on the history of his dying.
All right, Joe, get one from this angle, huh?
Yeah, hold on while I focus, will you? Hiya, Danny. Okay, that's good. Got it. Now get a shot of all that food. Oh, what a banquet this guy laid out for himself.
Danny, come over here. This'll interest you.
It never interests me, Doc. What have you got?
Val Dane, the novelist. Ever read any of his stuff?
No.
Neither do I. The wife does, though. Says she's mad about him. But she went mad over Rebecca of Sunnybrook Farm.
Well, let's have tea some other time, huh, Doc? Tell me about Dane.
Hey, first tell him about me, huh, Doc? Tell him about me.
Oh, yeah. Danny, this is
Clem Picasso. Yeah, that's who I am. Picasso.
Picasso. Haven't I heard your name someplace?
Sure you have. Clem Picasso, the painter. I paint flagpoles.
That's where it was. You were painting a portrait of a flagpole for Dane, is that it?
Nah, you don't understand. I'm the real article. Let me tell you about me.
Yeah.
If it wasn't for me, you guys wouldn't even know Dane was dead.
Tell me more about yourself.
Well, I was painting a flagpole on top of this building, see? All of a sudden came a gust of wind. I grabbed hold of the pole, dropped my pail of paint right through that skylight there, see? I look for spilled paint. I find a dead man. That is the experience that happened today to Clem Picasso, flagpole painter. Unforgettable.
It'll live in my memory, too. You got anything to add to that, Doc?
Only this, Danny. This room is a fortress. Dane must have built it on top of his penthouse for a retreat. It's ventilated by an air conditioning system. The only source of outside light is that skylight, and that's at least 30 feet from the floor.
Mm-hmm.
There's no phone, and the room was locked and bolted from the outside. Dane couldn't get out. This place is bare. No writing materials, nothing.
Yeah, like a tomb. Maybe he needed this kind of atmosphere to think.
Maybe. All the boys found when they broke in here was Dane and that table, loaded with food, all jarred. Fruits, chicken, all sorts of good things to eat.
What's the matter, Doc? You hungry? Just tell me how Dane died.
He died of starvation, Danny.
Huh?
Yeah, all that food and he died of starvation. Curious man, this Val Dane. Now, Danny?
I could have dropped it right there. Val Dane, I told myself, had committed suicide by starving himself to death, thereby obtaining new material for his next novel. That's what I told myself. That's how much sense it made. And that's why I couldn't drop it. In New York, hardly anybody dies in a vacuum. A man as famous as Val Dane never does. There has to be a close friend or relative to break the news to, and in a case like this, to question. It wasn't tough to find out that Val Dane had a wife, now divorced, and a city directory said she lived on West 79th Street. It was apartment 105. As simple as that.
Yes, what is it?
You're Mrs. Dane?
Well, only approximately. Mr. Dane and I are divorced. I've kept his name for my son's sake.
Danny Clover. I'm from the police.
Oh, how interesting. We've never had a caller here from the police. Won't you come in?
Thank you.
I do hope you'll stay until Jimmy comes home. Jimmy is my son, Mr. Clover. I'm sure he'd love to hear the experiences you'd have to tell him. In here, the living room.
That's quite a collection of glass toys there on the floor. Clowns, building sets, animals, and all in glass. Jimmy must be an unusual boy.
Oh, yes, he is. That's all I have left in life, Mr. Clover. To make him happy.
There's something I have to tell you that might make you quite sad.
About Jimmy?
No, it's about your former husband, Val Dane. He's dead. Oh,
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.